Robin Williams looks 40, but he's actually 10 years old, and Jack.
David Bowie and Dennis Hopper promote the meteoric rise of the artist Basquiat.
And after the big earthquake, Kurt Russell surfs down Wilshire Boulevard in Escape from L.A.
Has a strange medical problem in Jack. He's growing at four times the normal rate, and so at the age of 10, he looks like a man of 40. And his parents wonder if he can go to a regular school. I'm Gene Siskel of the Chicago Tribune.
And I'm Roger Ebert of the Chicago Sun-Times. Robin Williams has had a lot of success over the years in playing grown-up kids and other kinds of misfits, but here I think he finally runs out of luck. Jack is a movie that never seems to have really thought about what it would be like to be 10 years old and in a grown-up body. Instead, it just takes that premise and throws sitcom ideas at it. Look at this scene. One of Jack's schoolmates has talked him into impersonating the principal. Well, that's a passable comedy idea, but the way it's handled here is all wrong. This isn't a 10-year-old talking. It's Robin Williams doing one of his characters.
So tell me, what happened to Principal McGee? I just talked to him on the phone.
I don't know what happened to Mr. McGee. Mr. Powell?
He got diarrhea.
Diarrhea?
Yeah, he got diarrhea. And he spewed. Threw up. Yeah, he had the squirts. He had the diarrhea.
Oh boy, that's more than I needed to know.
And that's Fran Drescher from TV's The Nanny. Jack becomes popular with his classmates because he's big enough to buy Penthouse magazine.
And they don't give you no trouble in buying them? Like, they don't ask for ID?
No, I just don't shave for a day. I look like 50.
Only a few scenes in the movie feel like they involve a real 10-year-old inside that big adult body, and most of those scenes also involve Jennifer Lopez as his fifth grade teacher.
What kind of foods do you just hate?
Broccoli.
Broccoli.
Makes you
yeah.
fart.
Two things. It could have been funny or it could have been believable. For me, it was neither one. And I don't know who it was made for. Either kids are going to feel uncomfortable, I think, with the growing up stuff, and adults won't like the slapstick and juvenile stuff. It's kind of amazing to note that Jack was directed by the great Francis Ford Coppola, who was too talented to be grinding out stuff like this.
Well, that to me is the biggest surprise of all. When I saw Coppola's name on it, mm-hmm. as the credits began, I was kind of excited. Mm-hmm. Then I was shocked because, Roger, I can't point to a single scene in this movie and say, that's a Coppola shot. Mm-hmm. Forget about the awful screenplay that's involved. But now, it's well known that Francis Coppola just bought additional acreage for his vineyard, and he's producing wonderful wine there. Niebaum Coppola. I like the 84 vintage.
Okay,
but I also have very good taste, Roger, and Jack stinks. It is really bad, and for all the reasons that you mentioned, Robin Williams is just doing his shtick, and to go into the bathos of whether Jack will survive or perish mm-hmm. is really sickening at that point. I think it's a very bad movie.
I wonder if maybe he was thinking of the success of Peggy Sue Got Married, which is about an older woman who goes back and inhabits her teenage body, and he maybe thought he could repeat that formula, but Peggy Sue had a lot of truth in it.
Oh my God.
It was about real life. It was about real feelings. This movie
and it was
is
adult.
Just,
it was adult
yes,
and
this
adult.
This movie is contrived from one end to the other. It's a real disappointment.
Tremendous disappointment. Okay, next movie. And it too stars Robin Williams, but in a better role than Jack. Couldn't be worse. It's a familiar role for Williams, the genie in the latest Disney Aladdin sequel, Aladdin and the King of Thieves. Another straight-to-home video picture, but I think this one could have worked in theaters, and Robin Williams is the reason. He's absolutely arresting every time his character and voice appear on screen, as in the terrific opening number in celebration of the wedding of Aladdin and Jasmine.
There's a party here in Agrabah. There's excitement in the air. People pouring in from near and far.
The Jasmine and Aladdin are gonna have a wedding. There's a party here in Agrabah.
Everybody will be there. So if you're a pauper or a show,
do something with your hair.
Even more entertaining is when the genie is the wedding coordinator. And he's even funnier, I think, than Martin Short's wedding arranger and father of the bride.
That's right, we're taking you to the marriage of the millennium. And who's this coming on the lovely stretch camel? There's Osiris. Oh, Osiris! Osiris, can we have a word with you?
Ah!
Oh, no, the crowd is parting. Who's coming? It's Moses!
Of course, the wedding doesn't go off without a hitch, provided by the gang of 40 thieves.
Got lots of grub to share.
Pull up an easy chair.
Pull up the 40 thieves.
A couple of good songs also help make Aladdin and the King of Thieves one of the few decent children's films around this summer. I do recommend it.
I enjoyed it, too. I thought that it had an interesting story that was a little bit more involved, a little more complex and challenging than I expected. I liked the animation, and once again, by bringing Robin Williams back, and he wasn't
in the
first Aladdin video sequel, I think they've gotten some of the magic that was in the first.
Absolutely. It would have worked in theaters. I think I'm sure they do their calculus and say it will make more money at home video.
Now, they have said that they do not release sequels to their animated films as a company policy. So there you have it, at least not in theaters.
Two thumbs down, way down for Jack. Two thumbs up for Aladdin and the King of Thieves with Robin Williams reprising his marvelous genie role. This film is only available on home video starting next week. It's not in theaters.